Hi, and welcome to the DGS YouTube tutorial video on Outlook 2016. My name is Josh, and I'm part of the team here at the DGS Help Desk. DGS is making some exciting new changes to some of the software that we're going to be using, and the purpose of this video is to help you get more acquainted with some of those changes and more familiar with some of the features in the software upgrades that you're going to be seeing. This playlist focuses on Outlook 2016. There's a lot of new features that have been changed in Outlook 2016, and this video is going to look at a handful of those changes. And in later videos, we'll discuss some of the other features that have been changed and show you how to perform various tasks. So let's get started. Okay, so one of the first things we're going to talk about in these Outlook videos is how to change the interface within Outlook. If you're using a laptop or a Surface Pro, or maybe you only have one monitor, you know that every square inch of your screen is valuable, and I'm going to show you how to get a little bit more space here to work within Outlook. So this is your ribbon. It's the same in all Office products that you're already used to, and then here's your different tabs that go along with the ribbon. Up here in the top right is this new Ribbons Display Options button. If you click on that, you'll see some different options on how you can hide or change your view around within Outlook. You can choose to show just the tabs and hide the ribbon, or you can choose to hide everything. And there you go, now you're in full screen mode, and that's about as much space as you're gonna get. So if you click back on the Ribbons Display Option button, you can click down here on the Show Tabs and Commands and bring everything right back. The other thing I wanna talk about here is if we go down here to the bottom left, we can see these different shortcuts to the different sections within Outlook. There's your calendar and contacts. And here are some more options. If you click on this and you go to the navigation options, so you can choose how many of these icons you see down below, and this is the order that they're going to appear in. So if I change this to show 5, right now we can see 3, it goes up to people, but it's not showing tasks or notes. And I click on OK, I can slide this over, and now I can see there's tasks and notes. But I don't like all that clutter down there, so I'm gonna bring this back down to 3, and I'm gonna click on OK. Now back down to 3. The other option that you have is, some people don't wanna see these little icons, so you can also get these shortcuts spelled out for you if that makes it easier for you to see or makes it more user-friendly for you. So you can uncheck the compact navigation option and click on OK. And now you've got a different way of viewing the same shortcuts. So it's just a quick look at some of the new changes in the interface for Outlook 2016. So the next thing we're going to take a look at is some changes that were made to the calendar, which are pretty neat. If you hover your mouse over the icon here, the shortcut for the calendar, you'll see this new calendar window pops open, and it shows you your monthly calendar view, and you can see some of what you've got planned out for the next few days. And you can see I don't have anything for today. My next appointment is tomorrow, but this updates right away. So if I click here on the to go to the actual calendar, and I'm gonna set up a little test appointment to show you it in action. I'm just gonna call it test and click on save. So now here it is, it's there. If I go back and hover over this, you can now see there it is, it's showing it right now. Something else that's neat about the calendar, if you go to whatever view that you're interested in, so I'm usually in my mail portion of Outlook, but if I want to have access to my calendar pretty easily, I can just hover over this, the window pops up, and then if I click on this icon here in the top right, I can dock the calendar in my view, so now I can be able to see my emails like I normally would, but over here on the right, I can see my calendar, so I can always kind of keep an eye on both my email and what's going on over here on my calendar. If you test that out and you don't like it, you can just close that by clicking on the X up here, and that removes it, and you're back to your regular view. So that's a quick look at some of the changes made to the calendar in Outlook 2016. Okay, so now let's take a look at some of the new features added to Outlook that are going to help us manage and communicate with our contacts. Let's go ahead and click on the People shortcut here in the bottom left corner. This brings us to a list of our contacts. Now my list of contacts is going to be different than yours. These are some contacts I've added for demonstration purposes. This contacts area is great for helping you easily communicate with both DGS and non-DGS employees. It's also a great way to stay in contact with vendors, customers, contractors, and outside agencies. You can also create contact groups so you can easily send out one email to a group of people like I can do with my lunch buddies. In a future video, we'll show you how to create contacts and contact groups as well as edit their contact card information, so stay tuned for that. Now I want to show you something that's really helpful that's new to Outlook. If you hover your mouse over the People shortcut, you'll see that my list of favorites is empty. Now I'm going to show you how to add contacts to your favorites list. Click inside the search box and type in the name of the person you want to add. Outlook searches through both the DGS email directory and your personal list of contacts. I'll add Jerry Seinfeld. I can add him by right-clicking on the search results and then click on Add to Favorites. I'll also add the DGS Help Desk. To remove contacts from your favorites, just bring up your list of favorites, then click on the button in the top right corner to dock the peak. You'll see your list of favorites appear here on the right. Inside that pane, you can right-click on someone from your list and click on Remove from Favorites. If you bring your list of favorites back up, you'll see your list has been modified. Favorites allow you to quickly send out emails. What's really cool about this feature is it allows you to email people quickly without needing to go back to the Mail tab. What you're already used to doing in order to send out emails is going to the Mail tab and either clicking on New Mail or going to the address book to send out an email. Either way, you're having to go to a specific tab within Outlook in order to send out an email. Well, suppose I'm looking at my calendar and I'm checking my availability for the day, and now I need to send someone an email. If I have them added to my favorites, I can simply bring up my favorite list, find the person I want to contact, and get my email started without having to leave the tab I'm looking at. So that's a quick look at the new favorites feature in Outlook. Alright, so that does it for this video. That's just a small handful of some of the new features and functionality that's changed within Outlook 2016, and we hope it helped. In future videos, we'll be covering some more of those features and show you how to perform various tasks. And stay tuned for those videos. Thanks for watching.